So 2009, you have a new ride. It sounds exciting. Can you tell us a little bit about your ride, maybe your challenges and your goals?
You know, when we envisioned building the Hyundai Genesis Coupe, when we got the approval from Hyundai, you know, our goal was to come up with a combination of the last 5 years of Rees Mullins Racing active involvement in drifting. And that is taking a long wheelbase vehicle with the dynamics and sideways action of the GTO, but combining the speed that we learned with the Solstice. And what you're seeing is that the car is very well balanced, it's very fast, and it's shod with new Toyo tire, Proxy R1Rs, which are amazing tire. And the combination of everything is just working really well here for the first time out. Let's go for a tour of the new Hyundai Genesis Coupe. Starting here, this is the platform, 3,400 pounds factory, race weight 2,800 pounds. Factory V6 putting out 310 horsepower. We tweaked it a little to 610. Going inside, come at some of the creature comforts. This car looks a little more like a GT300 car than it is a drift car, and there is a reason for that. This car is a dual-purpose vehicle. Effectively, the program that we put together to Hyundai is to show the diversity of the chassis. This exact same car will race Pikes Peak, it will do time attack, and it will also do drift. So when you come into the interior and you see some of the layouts, the driver is pushed back some 6 to 8 inches, meaning I cannot reach the dash. So all of our fuses and switches are all now on a gauge cluster on the center console. Driver is also sitting very, very low for weight distribution and G-force loads. And then coming into the rear of the car, we have a lot of aerodynamic aids. We have these big tunnels in the back that only work in a straight line to 15 degree slip angle, but they're going to work great on time attack and up Pikes Peak. So although they're maybe not as functional in drift, you know, the whole vision of the car will do every competition. The fuel cell is mounted centrally. We have a quick change rear end so we can gear the car for any course. Last year we had 3 different gear ratios, but we also had 3 different gear housings. Now we have 1 gear ratio, or it's multiple gear ratios in 1 housing. The car is potentially a little overbuilt, but when you start with a new platform, it's better to work backwards than continuously break things and get DNFs. So right now our water temperatures are beautiful, 180 degrees. Our intake air temperatures are great. The car is strong and solid, and it's fast.
Okay, Reese, we're done with the event, round one.
Yep.
How do you think you did, and how do you feel about it?
You know, when you go out as early as we did, you're always going to think that the judges were a little harsh on you. And to follow that thought up, you know, I just watched some video, and Stefan drove great, but in the hairpin that they dinged me on, saying that I didn't do what they were looking for, I watched him completely straighten up, pull the handbrake, initiate his drift again, hit a cone, and he still advanced. So, judges, what the frick are you guys watching? You know, we were on his door chasing him, and we had 5+ car lengths leading him. So, I don't know what you got to do this year to please these guys. Maybe I should join Drift Alliance.
Do you think it's the change of the judge or the change of the format that is causing this?
What's the deal?
Yeah, you know, it's hard to state. You know, again, this is coming from someone who got eliminated early on. Right. So yes, I'm a little frustrated. I had a lot of people here today that I wanted to do well for, and we were not given that opportunity. But you know, you come from being crowned world champion. Maybe these guys expect you to, you know, stick it on the wall in a brand new car every time. And I just wasn't ready to do that this weekend. We only fired up the car a week ago, and I wanted to leave in one piece, and we're leaving in one piece. But I also wanted some points as well.
So round two, though, looking forward now. How do you think Atlanta?
You know, I'm excited for Atlanta. We've won there. We've done well there in the past. But, yeah, to be honest, if the judging keeps up this way, we may need to go visit D1. They've got a great TV package, and maybe that's a better home for this place and this car.